Bronwen, obviously, and I'm designer at Making Pretty. Never live and work with the same person, number one, ever. You just get sick of each other. Not that I've ever done that, but I just know that there is no way that I could have lived and worked with Sarah, and she agrees completely the same way. I'd also say, as much as you want to live with some friends, there are friends that you know will be unbearable to live with, because even as friends, you love them to bits, but they're just a nightmare. Don't feel sorry for them and don't live with them. Usually follow your gut with regards to housemates. If it does feel right and you feel like you're going to get on quite well with them, you probably do. I was very fortunate and I made some of my best friends at uni with people that I lived with, and I didn't actually go to the same university as them, I just lived with them. And if you don't like them, if you do feel like you're not going to get on with them, it's probably because you're right, and you won't. But I would say this is probably the hardest things that I've ever had to do, is finding a house. It's incredibly stressful. You have to go through multiple agencies. You have to bargain hard. I'd say be prepared to put your foot down as well on with them, with especially agents. If you're going to go direct landlords, I would say check the landlord out first. Ask for kind of some sort of recommendation from previous tenants. Be assertive with them. They'll show you houses higher than you can afford. If there's a budget, stick to your budget. Make sure that you're never going to go over it, because they will constantly try and push, and you might get yourself in a situation where you can't afford it each month. It's the worst. We turned around and said, is any of them within our budget before we even leave this place, like to go to see the houses? And they would either say yes or no. If it was no, we wouldn't go. Refuse point blank to go and even see the house. And then when it comes to fees, I would say always ask for them to lower their administration costs. We were asked to pay £290 each. I point blank refused and I paid £200 each, which is still a lot, but it's, you know, we've saved ourselves 90 quid each, so
absolutely.
Make sure you ask. You can't, there's no harm in asking.
Yeah.
Damp everywhere. damp is a big one, because obviously a lot of the houses in London especially are single glazed, and that lets a lot of damp in. Gas on the hob, because electric hobs are the worst. Furniture, I check all furniture just to see if things are working. So like check that, like it sounds silly, but pull up mattresses and check the bed slats, because a lot of the time they're broken. I check under curtains, because that's where a lot of the damp hides. And I check always check to see how the curtains feel. I know it sounds really silly, but if they're actually quite cold and sticky, then usually there's some sort of something in the house. I'd also say check what furniture is included if you are going for a furnished. Be really specific with everything.